I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making bacon-wrapped Little Smokies. You're probably familiar with Little Smokies. Here I have a package that I've opened so I can get into it, but you can see the label on it. These are beef smoked sausages, and this is a 12-ounce package. And I think by calculating the number per serving and the number of servings, that there should be about 35 in here. So that will help you to plan on how many you're going to get. Now these are going to be wrapped in bacon. Here's my bacon, and I need each slice in thirds, but I can do a few at a time probably. So I'm going to grab three slices out. That one is longer, maybe I stretched it, and fold it over in approximate thirds, and then just use some scissors to go through here and make cuts. So a cut there and a cut out here will give me some pieces that are approximate thirds. Then I'm going to grab a little smokie and a 1/3 piece of bacon and just wrap this. And it goes all the way around almost twice, at least 1.5 times. But you want to do that because it makes it nice and secure. Then you need some toothpicks, and I don't want to dip into my unused toothpicks, so I put some out on the counter. And I want to spear this and let it go all the way through. And I wouldn't go to the very edge because that has a tendency to rip out. So about there, and then all the way through, and that's what you have. Now this needs to be placed on a cookie sheet if you want a baking pan, but I'm going to use my broiler pan, which you've seen me do this a lot. I line the bottom with aluminum foil, actually it goes over the edges, and then the top, I put a piece of aluminum foil, and I go through with a knife like this and find the holes underneath and make openings so that the grease can drop down. And I'll be putting them on this broiler pan and putting it in the oven because we will be baking for a good amount of time and then we will be broiling. So I think that's better than letting it sit in the bacon grease, but that's up to you. If you want to use a baking pan and just put them in there, that's fine. So I have probably about 34 of these left to go. They may not be exact, but I'll be back to show you what they look like before they go in the oven. We were able to get 36 bacon-wrapped little smokies. And you could put these in the oven right now if you want to do them like this. They will be delicious, but they will be even better and have more calories if you add brown sugar. So we're going to have a treatment that's kind of sweet and salty, and the sweet part is coming from some dark brown sugar. So I have a cup that I just had sitting over to the side, and I'm going to take my hand to sprinkle over the top. And I've probably used half of my half cup, so quarter cup. Some of it's going on the top, some of it's going to be there for the little smokies to lie in as they bake. So this goes to a 325 degree oven and gets baked. So put it on the middle shelf and we'll let it bake slowly. Maybe as long as a half hour, even more. We'll take a look at it and see how well done the bacon is. And the final part will be moving it up to a shelf that is fairly close to the burner on top, turning it to broil and watching very carefully and letting it crisp up a little bit on the top. So I'll let you see it after it's at that point. Our bacon-wrapped little smokies are done. I left them in the middle of the oven for 40 minutes at 325 degrees. And this is what they look like. And for me, this was done enough. We're going to serve this into a little bowl. If you want an accompaniment for your bacon-wrapped little smokies, something plain is the best, and I'm just using some Ritz crackers here. And you don't need anything at all because they have plenty of flavor on their own. So I'm going to bring one of them over. And obviously this is finger food. Take that out. And we'll see how it tastes. Mmm. Taste that brown sugar. The little smokie is juicy, really good. But done all the way through, and for me, that's a necessity. It was done already, already cooked. But for me, it has to be heated. In fact, the outside needs to be crisped a little for me to enjoy it. And the bacon, of course, has to be crispy. Tastes wonderful. And one thing I can say about this dish is that it's just really easy to put together. It doesn't take long, and it looks attractive. So when you put that on your Easter table, it can serve as an appetizer, and I think people will enjoy it. And other than Easter, you can just put it out when you're watching some kind of sports or a movie or something like that. Everyone always enjoys it. I would serve it warm, and if it cools off or you have it in the refrigerator overnight or something, then I think I would heat it in the microwave or put it in aluminum foil and heat it in the oven before serving it again. Enjoy!